Hello everyone, it's Serpent, and welcome back to another episode of ImpSMP server stuff. Slightly messed up intro that time. I seem to have trouble with this one for some reason. Anyway, as you can see right now, I'm gathering some wood for the wood shop. I haven't actually, stocked it up at all, which, might be confusing to some of the other, I guess, imps. anyway. So, I'm stocking it up right now, and I'm going to grab some spruce wood as well as the birch and oak, because that's a good idea. It's a good idea to have more than one type of wood. Other people might not want to build with spruce all the time. Frankly, I don't. Anyway, hold on. Space, come on. You're slowing up the video. So, I have decided that, basically, I don't want to build my main base in the end, like we were planning, or like I was planning, I don't know, because that would mean I'd probably lose my stuff at least 4 times in the process, which doesn't sound particularly interesting and nice in my view. So, I'd rather build it in the overworld, like we were originally planning to do. Need more bones. And that basically means that it needs to be quite a bit bigger than what we have now, and that will involve tearing down the structure we currently have and rebuilding it, but bigger. Which does mean that we do have to tear it down. Which is a shame, but still, I haven't actually gotten that far through it. And, how many do I have? Only 29? Wow. So, that's what we'll be doing first this episode, and then hopefully we can get the whole thing up, because I know last episode was constantly delayed, but we were originally going to try and get the whole thing up last episode, but due to the constraints of our materials, we had to repeatedly go fetch more, and that, and then I died in lava, and it was all very sad and painful. But hopefully this episode will go a little bit more smoothly. That would be nice. And if so, we should, in theory, get the main base up and running. Well, I've got a stack of each wood that I have, and now I'm going to chuck it in the shop. Hopefully we'll start getting some diamonds. Alright, we do get the last part. Well, the shop's all stocked up. There still aren't any torches in there, but it's stocked up. One of the things we do need in order to rip down our space station is silk touch, and that I don't have. I used to, but then both pickaxes with silk touch broke. So, I don't have that now, and basically, I've set up this nifty little portal here to go to our zombie farm, since the Ender is still down for some strange reason. And then there's also this enchantment table and no anvil. Oh wait, I do have iron on me. Never mind. I take back that. So, since we don't have silk touch on a pick, and we have no way of getting that, then I think probably the only solution is to do something that doesn't require silk touch on a pick. Very good deducing right there. Anyway, so I'm going to... So we, on the server, as you know, we don't have an ender, and hold on, what was I doing? Oh, right. On the server, we don't have an ender, and that's annoying. The one we do have is currently not up and running, and that's slightly, well, that's also quite annoying, but basically, here's my Depth Starter 3 boots. I'm going to be when it is working, the one we have, the Endermen aren't killed in one hit, and that can slow things down considerably. So it can our current one can be made significantly better by making the platform the correct height up. And basically, I think I'm going to build a personal end render and make it look good too. Right. So I'm going to be using clay, hardened clay and obsidian because that's stuff I've got a lot of and it will look good in the end. Blue stained hardened clay. So now the step is to collect some clay and cook it because I don't have a lot of hardened clay. That one I don't have a lot of. And yes, I do know we have a mesa. It's just that this is a lot quicker since the mesa is so far away. It's quicker to do this since I only want a very small amount. We only need a small amount, so the mesas. We might as well not walk that whole way to the mesa. Well, we've got a good amount of clay now, so now we just need to cook it up. Like that. So, now we just dye it. And then we can take our stuff and use it in the new end render. So we shall build it out over there, and I'm going to be clever about this. I'm going to chuck all my stuff into this shulker box right here. Aha. And then all I shall take is two stacks of dirt and the torches. Now if I die, I don't have to care. Now that we have the bridge into nowhere, we can start work on the actual thing. So, actually, I should probably get some blocks for the platform. Black glass will do. Okay. That way, nothing spawns on it. I should have also brought some food, but whatever. So, this is going to look quite nice. I think I'll probably just make a little circle around the spot where the guys drop, where the Endermen drop. And hopefully that will look decent. Alright, I'm reasonably sure that this whole thing is completely holeless, so I think that's all good. Now I'm definitely going to add a border of black glass panes around it, because otherwise that would just be certain death. Alright, there's now a glass pane in every conceivable spot you could fall off so far. There will be more spots you can fall off, but not yet. Hold on. Right here is the center. Okay. Actually, that should be a torch. Torch eye are better. So, now the next step is to build the drop shaft for them, and I'm reasonably certain that goes up 43 blocks above this one. Yeah, before that time lapse went too far, I wanted to just get a shovel so that I could get down when I had actually gotten up. So this is the 43rd block up from that down there, so I'm pretty sure this is the correct height. Six black stained glass left over, it's not bad estimating. Okay, now we extend this platform up here, and then once we've done that we can actually we'll need an endermite and also a name tag for the endermite to keep it from despawning, but it's actually not that far from done. This isn't actually such a big project. Well, there we go. It's got a sort of cross pattern and then a little border of obsidian. It's kind of cool. And then if we go down and break down our pillar, then we shall have a successful and functional drop shaft. And there we go. All is done. Now what we need to do is get an endermite up there, and then, get an endermite up there and name it. So that involves a name tag. Name tags aren't something that I have an abundance of, unfortunately. I suppose I could probably ask one of the other people on the server for a name tag. Or I could build an AFK fish farm. Well, an Enderman's fallen down, so hopefully when we punch him, he'll die. Yeah. Okay. Great. That works. I'm not quite sure why he fell down, but who cares? Anyway, I have looked up AFK Fish Farm for 1.11 by Panda. It's gorgeously simple. Panda is so clever. Anyway, Panda 4994, I think. In any case, I'm going to be building that because it's so simple. And then we can do an AFK session, get a name tag, rename the thingy that comes out when you end a pearl, and then the Enderman farm will be up and running completely. I'm going to be moving this up into my base later, which is fine because it's so completely simple. I need cobble. Darn it. The cobble is gotten. Now, basically, what you do is you just go plop, and then, I need a chest. You go plop, and then you forget something. Then you put a chest here, and then you forget that you need a hopper. And then you place the forgotten hopper right there with a water bucket on top, but first I need to block that in. Hold on. You block it in, and then I think you put a slab there, or hold on. How would you block the water? Right, you put a slab there, and then you plop your iron door down there with a note block on the back, and then a slab not on there. Put the slab there, give me back my slab. Then you put the other slab on top of the note block. Come on, just give me. Okay. And like that. Now it won't make noise. And then you can plop some water down right there. And then over on the sides here, you plop these, and then you break these. And trip wire hook there and there. And then you put string in the middle. And then over here, you do that. With some redstone there. And that's that. Well, that's that, I suppose. But now we can actually use the fish farm. It's pretty simple, see? So I suppose I should probably just toss my wood on the ground. I should probably just make a nice double chest. Sniff. Okay. There. Make a double chest. And then plop that down, and now we can just go AFK. Well, in hindsight, it probably would have been a lot easier just to build the thing indoors, but now I'm going to do an AFK session. Hold on, there's a hole there. I have to patch up so a skeleton doesn't shoot me. I'm going to do an AFK session and go eat a snack or something. Well, never mind about that hole. It's done, let's go have a snack thing. Turns out it doesn't work so well when you don't have a good connection to the server you're on. So these mobs. Anyway. So what we need to do is build a little clock on it to manage the delay itself, as opposed to it being managed by, I don't know, us or something. Because apparently we're not good enough. Sniff. So, we just need to add a couple pieces. It's not too difficult, just something like that, and then, watch this, okay. Okay, come on. Oh, you can jump up two blocks if you're poisoned or burning or something, because you get jumped into the air a little when you get damaged. It's a pain, but it's a nifty pain. Anyway, now we get rid of this as well and replace it with the last repeater, set to 4, and then a block on the face of that, and all that's good. Hopefully, this should now be working. So if we do this, ha, that's good. Okay, wait for the fish. Fish are lazy biters. Okay, yeah, success. Okay, this actually works a lot better than the one I had on my single player world. That one, it took me about 40 minutes just to get it to go into a sustainable rhythm. And then it generally lost that rhythm after halfway through the AFK session, so this is actually quite a lot better. Now it's time for the snack. Well, it's actually been quite a lot longer than just enough to have a snack, but I did get quite a few stuffs, including 4 name tags, which should be enough, I think. I also got a mending book, which is always a plus, and a bunch of bows, which I can turn into good bows. So, I think it's probably about time to fix up the Endermender once and for all. I was just doing a little testing to figure out when the Enderman would attack and see what I could guard the Endermite with, and I found out something a little nifty. Look, see? The Enderman isn't attacking that Endermite because I spawned it in with a spawn egg. But if I, hold on, Ender Pearl, where is it? If I make an Endermite with an Ender Pearl, I'm pretty sure. Come on. There, yeah. It attacks the Endermite now. It's kind of nifty. Well, I'm going to be using a design like this. In fact, this design exactly, where this is the level of the spawning platform, and then over here is the contraption, and then up top is the little thingy, which I can't remember the name of, Endermite. It won't be made of dirt, don't worry. And as you can see, if you're just trying to recreate this yourself, I'm using the pressure plates, triggering the torches, and being update detected by the observers into the pistons to make this sort of, wherever you stand, you'll be pushed off into the pit of eternal pain. It doesn't work so well on players, I suppose. But whatever, it's because I'm only too high, I think, maybe. Anyway, either way, hold on, weird. Anyway, it works fine on the Enderman. Look, sometimes one gets stuck a little, but as you can see, they're all basically getting in, and then when that one moves, he'll be shoved in, or if he gets bumped by one of the Endermen from the Endless Stream, they'll also get shoved in. See? So it's a pretty good system, and I think it'll work. So let's go build that. I hate that moment where you realize that you've left something you absolutely need behind. You have to admit, that looks pretty cool. It is now time for the interesting part. I must, well, I think you probably probably know the drill. I'm going to enderpearl here until I make an endermite. They're not being very cooperative right now. Hold on, I want to eat. Okay, and back to it. There, okay. Now we name him, and then we try and get him in this minecart. Not only must we get him in the minecart, we also need to get him in the minecart on the side that he's trying to beat me into. There. Great. Okay. Quiet you. Is there any way I can get out? I don't think so. Okay. Get that, and then, come on. Oh. Eat. Come on. Okay. Good. Now we push him back into that corner. And, actually, I'm fairly certain we are now done. We just need to remove the blocks, and all will be well. Also, I need to make sure that that is indeed the right side. But I'm about 80% sure it is, so it's a good percent. Yes, indeed, it's the right side. So, I'm pretty sure we can get rid of all of that, and then also all of this, and that thing over there, and these blocks, and drop him down onto the little glass pane there. Haha! Success. Okay. Hold on. Is he a little bit too high? I'm pretty sure that's good. Let me check. Yep, all is well, and those two Endermen are indeed, in the hole now. So, it remains to be seen how I'll be able to get down from here, but I'm pretty sure it'll all go reasonably. And whoosh! Okay, that should be good, and hopefully the Endermen that will be to come will all be readily available and also one-hit kills. Obviously these won't be because they didn't fall the right distance, but the ones after these, ow, the ones after these should. So, hold on. It's not being very quick right now. This isn't a good sign. Oh, I see flashing lights. Ha. Hello? Enderman? Well, the problem is that there are too many Endermen up there for my apparently inadequate system, and I think that might be because of the fact that they all sort of clogged up at the beginning, so I'm hoping that if I go away and then come back, the farm will sort of fix itself. So that's what I'm going to do, and if not, I'll have to rethink the design, but it's not a big deal anyway. So ideally, at this point, they'll have all despawned, and we'll be getting a more reasonable stream of Endermen, as opposed to the massive clump we had at the beginning. So, no, they should be coming in faster than this. Wait, hold on. Ha. Yes. It's hard to tell, really. The platform might just be small. Oh, see, now all the torches are off right now, which means there are Endermen standing on them, standing on top, which means it's clogged up. So it's not a good enough system, unfortunately. That's a shame. Although, how are they off when there are Endermen, hold on. How are they? So, there's a piston arm right above the pressure plate that the Endermen are standing on, so those shouldn't be on for any length of time, really. I'm slightly confused, but I'm going to rethink the design, I guess. Well, I've come up with this design, and it's quite a lot more simple, and it also works quite a lot better. So if we stick all these Endermen in, you can see that they'll just toof down into the hole. Easy as that. We can't go any closer with the blocks here, because if we do, then they won't run around to there, they'll just walk off the edge. But even if they stand there, they'll sprint straight towards the closest point, which is this hole. And that's pretty nifty, and it also works excellently. And we won't have to move the Endermite, which is really, really good. So let's build this. It should probably take very little time. Well, good to know I can survive the fall. I'm nearly positive that at least one of those Endermen is angry at me. This could go badly. Peek. Yeah, okay. They all have to go. Alright, I need to move them from here to there. This hopefully won't be too difficult. Get over there. Come on. Scooch. Yes. Yes. He's moving in the right direction. Okay. Food would be nice any day now. Okay, good. I don't want this to die. I may be taking that off pretty quickly. Okay. It's about 10 now. 11, okay. 10, 9, okay. Yeah, I'm taking it off now. And putting it in this shulker box. Now if I die, it won't vanish. So, I don't know. Anyway, I'd like some more armor, but I don't think I have any. Where'd my shulker box go? The purple one. Hello? Purple shulker box? Peek. Ah, good. It's down there. So, yeah. This guy should now be, all... Oh, don't want to break the wrong one. Uh-huh. Good. You go too. And all the wood goes now as well. And hopefully this is perfect. And we shall have no more problems. This... Okay. I was going to say there should be a block there, but there shouldn't be, because we're removing all the scaffolding blocks. Anyway. Oh. I told you there should have been a block there. Right, so there's the chute, and ideally, this will all work. The trapdoor, the pressure plates there are for mob spawn blocking, to so that none of the Endermen spawn up here and can hit Zaniac. So, I am missing a piece of obsidian, which slightly ticks me off, because that means I'll have to pillar down and then pillar all the way back up. Hold on, is there a block under this? Okay. Is there a block under this? Okay. I'm not very trusting of my past self. And for good reason, too. Well, the Endermen are falling a little bit off. They're falling down here, and that's because I haven't, ow. Really? You noticed me? How rude. Ah. Go. Oh. Okay. There. I can't see them against the black background. It's not fair. Anyway, the Endermite there, it's supposed to be, a little bit scooched closer to the drop chute than it is currently. And that's just basically causing the Enderman to not run close enough. They're not seeing how much closer the block they should be running to is, so they're not running to it. Anyway, I need to scooch the Endermite closer to that drop shaft on its little pinnacle thingy, and then we should have a functional farm. Will I make it before I die of starvation? Who knows? Uh-oh. This is getting sort of bad. Next question. Will I make it before my items despawn? This is pretty slow. We're up to 17 deaths. And at this point, we did make it before the items despawned. Which is always a plus, actually. Come on! Scooch. Okay, I think he's scooched. Yeah, looks like. You stay out of this. Oh, come on, I punched him. This is no longer funny. Okay, maybe it's a little funny. Up to 18. It's not even a prime number anymore. We'll try that and see if the Enderman will chase it correctly now, and to the correct block. It shouldn't be, hold on, yeah, I think it should be good. Fingers crossed, hopefully, all that stuff. Toes crossed. Oh, ah, no, no. Crud. Not again. I'm going. and I'm staying here. Okay. I'm pretty sure I saved my Endermite there. If not, rip Endermite. Well, rip Endermite. Time to try again. Cue the Enderpearl spammage. You know, these things aren't nearly common enough. Although I think many people would disagree with me on that. Yay! Okay, name him. And then, hello? Come on. Step in the minecart. Good. Good boy. And then we break the minecart rail. And then we break the other minecart rail. And then we stuff him in the corner. Okay, good. He can't reach me there. Now, we must do this, before we, go down, because then there won't be any Endermen. Ow. So rude. And into the glass pane corner. Oh, well, I think he's about there anyway. Hopefully my falling didn't just shove him off. Okay. Whatever, I'll just shove my face into him a little bit more. Okay. Now, I know I've said this a lot this episode. Ow. But I think we should have a functional farm now. Again. Actually, before we go down, I'm going to be mildly clever. And, yeah, I'm going to be mildly clever and plop a glass pane right there to hopefully stop Enderman teleporting onto his glass pane and smacking him in the face. Then I'm also going to do the same with these. Never mind. Go away, smartness. I'm pretty sure Endermen don't teleport or can't teleport when they're angry, so that's basically just a random, needless precaution anyway. So hopefully that won't matter, and if it does, rip Endermite again. Endermen should now be spawning. Why are you here? This is where you should be falling, bub. Well, on the bright side, there are plenty of them. I am ever so slightly idiotic. Those apparently also need to be glass. By neglecting to notice that, I also managed to cause this guy to be pushed a little bit too far, because, I wasn't supposed to push him quite that far. I thought I was, since it didn't work, but I wasn't, actually. Anyway, so I'm going to give him a bit of a nudge back until that Enderman gets angry. Good. He's not running, though. If I get rid of that. Oh, wait, maybe it's because I, blocked off his path. It's just one mistake after another. Well, I'm not going to say it, but I think you get the general idea at this point. Yes! They are indeed falling in the correct hole. Yay. Fresh for the happy time. Sure, that's right. One thing I do need to do is eventually I need to make the platform quite a lot bigger, because right now there aren't nearly enough Endermen spawning. But, it does work. So, yeah. No one saw that. Okay, that's probably just one of them being pushed off by the other ones or something. I think I can live with that. But it's true that there aren't nearly enough Endermen spawning. Or at least not nearly enough Endermen being throwing themselves off the cliff. So I'm going to go up and check. I so wish I could just spawn Endermen up there to test it. Well, all of this complication is from basically the fact that these Enderman people are spawning weirdly, I suppose. But basically, they are spawning so that in a circle around this, as opposed to on one side. So it's a lot harder to direct them. And I'm just going to fix that by being lazy and doing this. I'm going to spawn-proof this entire side, and, okay. Should've used buttons, but whatever. Anyway, we'll see how the farm works after this. Why does this keep happening? It was a full health Enderman, too. It wasn't just that I was terrible at Minecraft and couldn't deal one heart of damage. That thing actually had full health, which does, I admit, confuse me. I don't really understand how. There's nowhere for... Oh, shut up. There's nowhere for him to spawn down at the bottom, and if he fell from the top, then he's dead. Really. I'm not quite sure what's going on with that, but oh well. Yeah. Oh yeah, I was going to also say something mildly informative about the progress. So we do have the whole thing. We do have them coming down the right shaft consistently. I fixed that by the spawn proofing, and also the. And now the only thing that's holding us back really is just that the platform is so unbelievably tiny at this point. So we need to expand that, and once we do, it should be working like a charm. Well, we're back up to a prime number at least. Thankfully, I don't think any of my stuff fell through that crack there. It was pretty close though. Anyway, that's good that it didn't, obviously. It's very nice that these are all one-hit kills, no matter what. So, really the next thing to do, I suppose, would be to expand the platform. Yeah. So, for the platform, we'll be needing a lot more blocks, and I think I'm just going to expand it with obsidian from now on, since that's really easy for us to get, since we've got the nifty little obsidian farm. Hold on, let's see if my elytra survived this flight. Yay! Okay. I put mending on them, by the way. So now we have a consistent source of elytra. Oh. Fooey. I forgot the other buckets. And here we are, back with all our buckets. I've been steadily gaining up a nice supply of these. Hold on, let me put a couple more things away. I've been gaining up a nice supply of these steadily, so we've got quite a few of them. So now we just head over here and scoop some more, and then do that some more as well. That's quite a lot of lava. So, now we just need to take all this back and stuff it in our farm, then we can put away on our spacebar and get loads upon loads of obsidian. Well, I say loads upon loads, but it's actually probably only about 2 stacks. yeah, this obsidian stuff is kind of expensive. Well, it's all filled up. There, and the hopper beneath too. That's going to be quite a lot of obsidian. Hopefully it'll be enough. And now we just stand here, hit the button, and start mining. Well, that's that, and we do have quite a good amount of obsidian. Oops. So, let's plop that into the thingy, the expand the platform. How on earth does this keep happening? That's just so unfair. Let's see, what did I lose? Oh wait, I didn't actually have anything good from the last time I died. Okay. Except I did have the elytra with mending. Which was the reason I died, actually, because I jumped and then I ended up pressing space and I flew off the bridge into the lava. Which is pretty stupid. Well, looks like we're not going to be expanding the platform just yet. Yeah. That's pretty stupid. Yeah, okay. Well, I think I shall just basically do some more AFKing over there then, so that I can get some books and other stuff like that, because I'll need it. On the bright side, that pair of elytra did last one episode longer than the other two did. Feeling a little bitter right now. Actually, it's all this bridge's fault. I was running around across here, and then I accidentally hit spacebar, and it sent, well, while I was in mid-jump, and then it flew me up, and I landed in the lava, and then I threw the ender pearls that I threw just, they literally went like that, only less far. I basically, at that point, I had no hope. On the bright side, at least that one wasn't my fault. The first two were. First I jumped off into the void without my elytra on, and then the second time I ender-pearled into a lava lake. This time it wasn't my fault, it was just a random glitch sort of thing. At least that's sort of in my favor. Well, the weather right now suitably sums up the end of this episode, but we did get the Ender up and running. Hopefully we will expand the platform soon, and hopefully by next episode I'll have some sort of gear to do the next episode with. In any case, hopefully this video was enjoyable, at least. The failures, the facepalms, the death, all of it. Well, deaths, plural. Anyway, hopefully it was enjoyable. This has been Serpent, and I think it's about time for my daily rage quit.